Hello there, and welcome back to this 300 subscriber and more special. A big, big thank you to all of you out there who considered subscribing. And if you're not subscribed yet, but still plan to do that, go tell me in the comments so I can thank you there as well. You guys are seriously amazing and I can't be happier. Another big thank you to all of the guys who helped me out with this video. Their Instagram, YouTube channel and every link is in the description, go check them out. So big shoutouts to Poplue, Askent and Motard for helping me out. I probably pronounced all these names wrong, but I can't help it, I'm not that good. Having some fun and quality time with teammates, friends or clanmates even can be really important in these trying times. So here's a video for you guys where I discuss the 5 best things you can do with your friends. A top 5 minigame tier list if you want. This best works in a private server, so if you don't know how to do that, check out my latest video on it. And without further ado, let's get into it. The first minigame you guys can play with your friends is a sniper free-for-all match. This works best in a private server since you only want to play with your friends and they all should be using snipers. If not everyone is able to one-shot, it can be frustrating for them and you, so just use something that isn't as tanky, for example a full agility build, and you'll be good to go. Games like this can be a lot of fun if it's a 1v1 or, like we did it, 4 players playing against each other. It is a blast every time you do it, as long as there's no absolute sniper god with you. But even then, you can practice some sick shots without anyone else using overpowered weapons disturbing you. And for that reason alone, the minigame ranks in my top 5. As you can see, minigames like this can even get competitive, and you trying to beat your high score against your friends is always the best experience. Okay, let's move on to the next one. If you plan on doing a revolver free-for-all match with your friends, you should be using the same gear. Not exactly the same, but like focus on agility only. Don't use any nerfs or pets or masteries at all. This guarantees that everybody deals the same amount of damage per shot, so you can all get the same 3-shot kill every time. If one of you uses something that nerfs the revolver, things get pretty boring because you basically can't kill him. So don't make the mistake we made and agree on the same build for everybody. I mean, they made no mistake, but I didn't tell them what to use, so I guess it's my bad. Seriously though, this is another one of the classic minigames you can play with your friends, and as long as everybody has the same stuff, you can do this as long as you want. Obviously, it best works in a private server as well, so no one uses overpowered stuff on you. But you don't care, you're unaware, keep moving like the scars aren't even there. It's in the air, like a blazing flare. Don't stare, cause the flames will burn us. I thought you were the one for me. That's why I gave you everything. Held you close by the stormy seas. Oh, you meant the world to me. I used to kiss your head when you cried for me. Hold your hand while the pain. The next minigame is a little bit on the strange side. It's called the Twister Only mode, and in this mode you basically only kill by using twisters. This can be especially funny because no one can nerf twisters, you just get pulled in whenever you get too close to it. So placing them behind walls and running away from your enemies while also trying to lure them into your traps can be really challenging and fun. This gets better with every player joining in, so you you better have a big squad, because one-on-one action is not that funny. If there are more than two or three players even in there, like we did, we were four and some randoms, no corner is safe, and you basically have to watch every step. If you happen to have the Vortex with its active skill, which is basically another twister you can use, that's fine by the minigame rules I made up, because it just adds to the fun. The more twisters, the better. And as you already see in the background, we changed the game mode again. This time it's grenades only. And I should have made this clear, because I think I wrote gadgets when I told them what to do. So not everybody's using the normal grenades, and only the normal grenades. But you should make this clear, because using a different grenade makes this not that much fun. You all should be using glass cannons, so a direct hit from a grenade gets you one hit. And you also should play this on a smaller map, because we basically couldn't hit each other. Still was very fun, and it's probably one of the cheapest gadget minigames you can play. Also, you can do this with every other gadget, as long as everybody's using the same. For example, ballistic knives or super grenades. Getting kills like this is actually quite difficult, and without using any slowing down weapons or stunning weapons, it quickly becomes harder than a sniper freefall. As expected, the amount of kills was pretty low, so after this we decided to go full tryhard, which is actually our fifth minigame. A lot of the time, whenever you play with your friends or clanmates, you agree on using the same stuff and everybody gets the same chances. But this mode is different. This minigame focuses on your ability to change your weapons and playstyle, also your nerfs and damage buffs, on the fly, while adapting to your enemy's weapon selection. You can finally flex your most overpowered builds and start piling up those kills. But be careful, other players might be able to 100% nerf you. This even was, in my opinion, one of the best minigames we played, because you normally won't play something like this in multiplayer. It's also interesting to see more overpowered weapons and creative builds just based around that single gun. There are still some underrated weapons out there which can, in the right hands, be devastating. So go have some fun with your friends, try new minigames, and let me know which one of those five you enjoyed the most. With all of that said, thank you once again, and we will see us in the next video. Bye!